Lights out, and we are racing in Moto3 here in Qatar. Brilliant start from pole position by Holgado. Rueda looked like he got left a little bit off the line on 99 bike. Ortola started second in P2nd.
Oh,
contact, big contact.
Rueda and Ortola, I think.
Rueda with a huge high side.
There's contact there with Ortola, which sends Ortola off.
It's a nightmare that's taken out two of the big hitters here in the opening Grand Prix. There is Furusato. He's got great early pace. Started in that 18th place, and he is firing on all cylinders. Seventh now.
Here comes Furusato. From Fernandez now up into the podium positions now for Furusato. And Alonso gets turn one all wrong. Furusato now up into second.
This has been a stunning first ever lap. And he now leads. He's wasting precious little time here. Picks off Holgado into turn six. Thank you very much. 18th to first. Furusato leads the Qatar Grand Prix. This is going to be a cracker. Holgado standing firm on the brakes. Furusato's not close enough. Alonso's got an awful lot of work to do on the inside of Poe as he goes in the first corner. But Alonso now down in P5. Alonso starting to work his way back towards the podium battle up into fourth place, albeit briefly, because Fernandez is going to tough it out. Really?
Oh,
no, Fernandez has gone down and he collects Vicente Perez as well. Here's Alonso on the inside of Rossi into 10.
Holgado's trying to defend this.
Here's Alonso.
Alonso now attacks Furusato.
Yeah, he senses this one. Alonso is proper up for this one. He knows he's going to attack all in here on Holgado. One corner remaining of what's been a cracking start to Moto3. On the inside comes Alonso. He picks up Danny Holgado. And David Alonso surely is going to win the opening Grand Prix of 2024 in Moto3. The Slipstream Showdown unfolds. And David Alonso wins an absolute corker in Qatar. What a way to kick off the Moto3 World Championship. It's lights out, and we are racing in Qatar in Moto2. Really good start from the second row by Tony Arvelino. Kinnett absolutely botched the start. Kinnett is going backwards. That was a horrendous start from the 44 bike from pole position. He's going to be struggling to keep himself inside the top 10 as they sweep through the first corner. A howler for Kinnett from pole. So through the first split, Kinnett pole to eighth place. A disaster in Doha early on.
Seventh now. It looked like he was up the inside of Zonta van den Goorberg. Kinnett very quickly up and running. That might be the best thing that could happen for the entertainment this Grand Prix, because he's clearly the fastest out there.
Kinnett's charge back towards the front has been very impressive indeed. He was as low as eighth at one point on this opening lap, already sided his way back through into fifth place.
And Kinnett ready to take the opportunity and move up another place. The door slams shut in his face as Arenas decides to go on the attack instead, and van den Goorberg getting involved too.
Oh, look at this. 3-4 abreast. They attack hard into turn 10. Brilliant early action here in Moto2. Side by side now, Kinnett and Arenas as they sweep through 11. Just on the inside goes Kinnett, getting busy now, isn't he, Kinnett? This is just surely a matter of time before he's able to dispense of Lopez. He's going for
it. Arenas goes through, Kinnett now into the lead. Remember, at turn one, two laps ago, he was eighth. He's already into the lead of the race midway through lap three. Here comes Lopez.
Oh, here comes Lopez from a long, long way back. He's going to run in hot, is he? No, he's going to bring it down to the apex. No, he just runs in fractionally wide. Kinnett will have the inside line through one, but not through two. And Lopez then on the cutback, back at the front. Here comes a Barry on a number seven, doing Sheen proud here. Brilliant by Barry Baltus. Easily eases through on Kinnett.
Aaron Kinnett was the runaway race favourite, but his victory odds look like they're fading fast here in the desert.
Yeah, they really do.
The medium rear tyre had completely gone. Kinnett, who was on that tyre, struggling.
He's running out of time here, running out of corners is Baltus. If he is to take an unforgettable first Grand Prix victory, who's going to take the spoils at the start of the Pirelli era? It is all coming down to a final corner climax here, isn't it? In Qatar, it's still Lopez from Baltus.
Baltus has to get as good a run as possible through turn 15, following through this left-hander. Lopez absolutely on the edge, but he's surely going to have to take the middle of the road and defend into 16.
Now or never, on the brakes into the final corner. Lopez defending quite superbly. Baltus, I don't think he's going to be able to get the slipstream out of the final corner. What an incredible race here. Lopez lights up LaSalle. What a way to start the new Moto2 era. He absolutely pulverizes the screen on that Bosque Oscuro chassis. Alonso Lopez is back on the top step of the podium. What a race!
Wow. Do you love MotoGP? Like, subscribe, and enjoy all the action.